Hello and welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos Blind.
I hope the murderer is caught soon. This lockdown is truly hampering my schedule for the week.
Oh, dreadful.
Agreed. I was supposed to go back to Byzantium today to play cards with the vice CEO of Hammersmith. And what about you?
You want a punch?
Oof.
You got your punch right here.
I was too. But it wasn't the vice CEO, it was the president of the company.
Really? What's her name?
That thing scared me.
If you don't know, then maybe you should try to be a little more cultured.
Wow, you told him.
I can't believe Helen's gone.
Ugh.
We're never going to get a sequel to Terror on Mars.
Yeah, I heard enough of that. Let's go report to... what's his name? Samples will be billed to your room. This comes in this way, huh? So they put flowers and candles for her and stuff? In memoriam. Oh. It's like, who the hell's standing over there? We need to see who? Report to Administrator Ludovico. Oh, I think we have to talk to him from our...
What floor would you like to visit?
Is that a different voice? This one sounds pissed. I was saying we have to go talk to him on our terminal. I'd like to visit the VIP guest floor.
Oh, so sorry, but you're not actually authorized to visit that floor. What authorized floor can I bring you to?
Bring me to the penthouse suite, then.
Next stop, the finest seat in the house.
Recording, gotta be around here somewhere. Rizzo's Ranger mask?
The misguided individual rifling through Ruth's belongings seems oblivious to our presence, Captain. Perhaps you should have a word with him.
Yeah. Hello? The
hell?
Whoa!
Sweet gibbering law! Where'd you come from?
Downstairs?
Sorry. Let me just get back in character. Whoa. It's not what it looks like.
Pretty sure it looks like Rizzo's mascot is in my room going through my things.
Looks can be deceiving, friend.
Sure,
for example,
sure.
What looks like misappropriation may, in fact, be a misunderstanding.
Not buying it.
I seem to have wandered into the wrong premises. I have mistaken this penthouse for the Rizzo's Ranger's locker room on account of my headgear cutting off my peripheral vision.
Hey, Ellie, rough him up a bit.
Really? Great. I think I even have my spare scalpel with me. The rusty one I never clean, not the good one.
Bonus.
Wow. Looks like you've got some mascots of your own, except they're heavily armed.
Yeah, with rusty knives.
I am acting on behalf of Mr. Black Hole Birdie, the Holemeister, the Hack Attack.
We know who he is.
I don't have a lot of time, but Mr. Birdie sent me to retrieve a message. Something he recorded for Ms. Bellamy while he was off his kilter.
Did you find anything?
Clothes, mostly. Couple tops, couple pants, couple pairs of socks. Didn't find a letter, and I'm trying real hard to stay positive about that. Will you meet me later, over at the pilot house? I swear, from the bottom of my employment contract, I will tell you everything I know about Ms. Bellamy's demise.
I don't trust you. Attack. You better tell me what you know, or they'll have to rinse your remains out of that mascot outfit.
What? But I can't.
Fess up.
Please don't hurt me. I'm sorry. I can't. Not here. I'm sorry.
You must.
The pilot house complex. Meet me there, and I'll tell you everything, I swear.
No.
The pilot house complex. Meet me there, and I'll tell you everything, I swear.
Don't let him go. Ellie, told you to rough him up. Where'd she even go? Well, there you are. I wanted you to rough him up a little bit.
I'm leaving my shoes on.
Whatever.
Everything's so soft and silky and expensive. Oh gosh, I hope I don't get any grease stains on the furniture.
Don't worry about it.
I do love all the wall space. So much room for trophies.
Pigsty! Slovenly! These premises are unsuitably disordered.
How would they be suitably disordered?
I sometimes find myself musing on who I used to think I was. It seems ridiculous in hindsight, but without my obsession, I never would have reached this point.
It's my obsession. Just my obsession. With Felix.
Is this how people in Byzantium live all the time?
Probably. Alright, let's go talk to Ludovico.
I understand there was an incident at the orchards. The pollination cycle began without my authorization.
Mm-hmm.
Fortunately, you managed to save most of the hive. The wasp ketos are essential to the orchards, you see. Losing them would have cost us months of production.
And more than a few lives, that doesn't bother you?
The orchards can be a dangerous place, but my workers understand the hazards.
Shouldn't be?
Something about this incident troubles me. The circumstances are suspicious. But let's concentrate on the matter at hand. Have you discovered anything?
I do want to say the plot thickens like a good investigator, but I don't smoke, so yeah, you can say that.
You have my attention.
Yeah, there's a few incidents. Dr. Blossom, Helen, Dr. Blossom is dead, murdered by an unknown killer.
That's deeply upsetting. Dr. Leora Blossom was an extraordinary scientist and a friend. We have a murderer on the loose, Inspector. Mm-hmm. As if the death of Halcyon Helen wasn't enough of a blow to our facility.
She was in trouble when I found her. The other workers had turned violent.
Her commitment to her NDA was admirable. I'll make sure to accelerate the payout of her death benefits to her next of kin.
Well, let's not leap to conclusions. I don't know who's behind her death. Not yet, anyway.
I wish you'd give me a little more information, Inspector. Leora was a friend. But I promised to leave this investigation in your hands, and so I shall. If there's anything else you'd like to share, you have my attention.
Gave you all the information I have. Helen insisted on touring the Rizzo's RR&DD lab.
Insisted? That's interesting. We'd scheduled a tour of the lab for Helen. Purely a public relations event to be held sometime in the indeterminate future. Then again, Helen and I were not well acquainted. I can't speak to her intentions.
What were you going to show her during the tour?
A little of consequence. We'd tour the grounds, pause at some locations appropriate for a portrait, let her shake hands with our scientists. Public relations.
She spent a little time at the orchards. I found evidence she was at a picnic.
A picnic? I don't recall approving a private social gathering at the orchards. I'll have to make a note of this information. Thank you for bringing this to my attention. Was there anything else?
Need permission to have a picnic? Someone stole data from one of your terminals in research and development.
That's troubling, to say the least. Any transfer of proprietary data is strictly prohibited without my permission.
Right, and this happened just before the Wasp Skeeto attack. Someone was trying to stop me.
Yes, I share your suspicions. Someone didn't want you following their trail.
Mm-hmm.
This feels like more than corporate espionage. Someone's playing with us, Inspector. And I have never in my life enjoyed games. Did you discover anything else?
Nope, but if I do, I'll let you know.
This incident at the orchards must be connected to Helen's murder somehow. I don't know how, but I feel it in my marrow.
Not your bones?
My apologies, Inspector. This case is under your jurisdiction, 5,000 bits. I leave it in your hands. When you're ready, I suggest a word with the hotel coroner. She should have finished her autopsy by now.
Okay. Hey, why was there a suspicious-looking Rizzo mascot in my room?
Why was there a suspicious-looking mascot in your room? I'm afraid I don't understand. Is this the lead-up to a joke?
Is there something about my tone that suggests I'm joking?
My apologies. I can tell you're not, as they say in Terra 2, twisting my limb.
I don't know why
there was a mascot in your room. The Grand Colonial doesn't offer that kind of room service, I think.
He had some pretty interesting things to say about Black Hole Birdie.
Such as?
Birdie convinced him to break into my room. You didn't know about this?
I most certainly did not. My policy toward Eridanos is one of, shall we say, benign negligence. I keep my distance and don't involve myself unless necessary. In any case, let me apologize for this unfortunate business. I'm sure this mascot meant no harm.
I'll take your word for it.
Was there anything else?
Nope. You're dismissed. That you were someone else skulking about. Right. You've discovered that Black Hole Birdie may have wanted to kill Halcyon Helen. Investigate what he was doing at the time of the murder. Someone broke into your penthouse. They're rummaging through your things. Are you going to let them get away with it? Confront the intruder. No, I did not. Go to the meeting spot. The Rizzo's Rangers mascot was sent by Black Hole Birdie to search the penthouse. He refused to speak more about it inside the hotel, insisting you meet him at the weather monitoring station on the Phaeton Pilot House. That's another island we have to go to? The man who chafed? Chief among Helen's many injuries and afflictions at the time of her death were signs of poisoning. Identifying who poisoned her and why could lead you to the real murderers. Speak with Dr. Goodnight to discover what she may have learned from Helen's autopsy. We still have to do the pool thing and the watchman and find the profitability. Okay. Meeting spot. Well, where's... Let's talk to Dr. Goodnight again. We'll not go softly into that goodnight.
What floor would you like to visit?
I'd like to visit the VIP guest floor.
Oh, so sorry.
Yeah.
What authorized floor can I bring you to?
The lobby, please.
To the lobby we go.
Yeah, I'm gonna try every time. Let's change it up, I guess. Ellie and Naoka. Dr. Goodnight. This was closed before. That was loud. Hi.
Bertie Holcomb is likely beside himself in grief.
Unless he's the one who killed her.
I was nearly attacked by a terror ray on my way here.
Good.
Mr. Kincannon really knows how to run a hotel.
Uh-huh. Bartender mechanical.
Greetings, attractive patron. Please allow me to improve your drinking experience with fine cocktails.
You know anything about the murder?
Error. This unit is incapable of murder, as it possesses no conscious will. The proper term would be destruction of company property. Neither this unit nor its corporate proprietor claim any responsibility for any destruction of company property that this unit did or did not commit.
You never know. She scrawled the word B, which could be Black Hole Birdie or Bartender Mechanical, right? That sounds pretty suspicious to me. Where were you at the time of the murder?
This unit is incapable of abandoning its post. This view of the lobby is all it knows, has known, or will ever know.
Too bad we don't have Engineering 100. I'm still not convinced.
For what it's worth, I don't trust it either.
Search failed. Suspicious data not found.
Alright, give me a drink, bartender. Do I need anything repaired? As a matter of fact, I don't want anything. Let's sell the junk, though. Okay. As you were. Don't move from that spot now. Good. Oh, this is not medical. Guy's still sitting there. Oh, replacements for the amplifier. Well, there's nothing on her. She, can you just close her eyes? Jeez. Hi.
Inspector, not a moment too soon. I've just finished my autopsy report.
Would you mind washing your hands before you give me anything?
Oh, don't be so squeamish. You won't find any viscera under my fingernails. I trimmed them just this morning. Ruth Bellamy was killed by plasma damage to the upper vertebrae, the occipital bone, and the cerebellum. If it's any consolation, her death was instantaneous and painless. I've also discovered a poisonous compound in Miss Bellamy's stomach lining ingested during her last meal. Toxic, but not enough to kill her. Spencer Woolrich complained of a stomach ailment around the same time period. I assumed he was being, you know, Spencer. But now I'm not so sure.
Someone was obviously trying to poison Helen.
Almost certainly. Well, possibly they were trying to make her extremely uncomfortable, but I suppose killing her would also satisfy that criterion.
You sure it wasn't just the hotel food, though?
The thought occurred to me. I tested this hypothesis by vacating the contents of my stomach and testing for the presence of the same toxin.
Ugh.
Slightly elevated levels of mercury and an alarming amount of blue food coloring. But other than that, no. I'm certain it wasn't, as you put it, just the hotel food.
Hey, when we were talking, you called her Ruth Bellamy, not Halcyon Helen.
Oh, how curious. I do believe you're right.
What's your first name?
I wonder if this has something to do with the autopsy process. She was Halcyon Helen up until the moment I brought her to the operating table. But as soon as I cut her open, I stopped thinking of her as Halcyon Helen. It's almost as if she stopped being an icon and became a human being.
I guess that makes sense.
I had a feeling you'd understand.
I noticed you had patient logs on your terminal.
I do keep logs of every patient I treat. Despite appearances, I'm not merely a coroner. I'm also the Grand Colonial's only, and therefore greatest, doctor.
Huh. Is that allowed?
I don't see the conflict of interest. As the hotel's doctor, I attend to the health of my patients when they're alive. As the coroner, I attend to my patients when they're dead. If I do my job as a doctor, I rarely have to call upon my skills as a coroner. And if a patient dies under my treatment, my coroner's report practically writes itself.
If this job ends up killing me, I don't want you anywhere near my body.
Oh, don't worry. I'm not going to harvest your precious organs. Salvaging is more Sublight's purview. I'm with Slug. We're different. We're professionals. What I'm about to tell you, do me a favor and keep this between us.
Lie and be dexterous. Cross your fingers behind your back. Inspector's honor.
That's what I like to hear. I'd much rather work for Slug than Rizzo's. Rizzo's makes a great show about the happiness of its workers, but I think it's all rather artificial. I'm paid well. I work hard. I'm given respect and a reasonable degree of freedom. Cedric Kincannon runs a tight ship. Most of us enjoy working for Slug.
Yeah, I don't see anything to rat on her about. Alright, I'll bear that in mind. Thanks.
Will there be anything else?
Nope. We gonna find anything new here? Let's just check. Oh, thought she was coming over as well. Chief among Helen's many injuries and afflictions at the time of her death were signs of poisoning. Identifying who poisoned her and why could lead you to the real murderer. Gain access to VIP floor. You'll need access to the VIP floor to continue your investigation. Speak with Spencer Woolrich. You want to say Woolrich. The autopsy report noted that Spencer Woolrich had complained of intense stomach ailment recently, raising the possibility that whoever poisoned Helen also poisoned Spencer. Speak with him in his room on the VIP guest floor. Right. Let's do that then. Oh, I want to see anything new. Ah! Welcome, Dr. Winifred Goodnight. Okay, so it's not B. Unless... Winifred? I don't know if there's a nickname for Winifred. Binifred? This is an automated reminder to make sure you clean the blood off your instruments. Autopsy report. Bellamy Ruth. Cause of death, plasma damage to upper vertebrae, occipital bone, cerebellum. An autopsy report on Ruth Bellamy, formerly Halcyon Helen. Could this be the apex of my profession? Bellamy's corpse shows evidence of several possible causes of death, but I have determined the killing blow was plasma damage to her upper vertebrae, occipital bone, and cerebellum. Death was instantaneous and painless. Frankly, her death may have come as a relief. She was unwell prior to the attack. High concentration of poisonous compounds in her stomach lining ingested during her last meal. Not lethal, but uncomfortable in the extreme. Spencer Woolrich complained of similar stomach ailments. Is this a problem common to professional actors? Well, you guys were already standing over here. Stop playing games with me. Ow. Hi. Are you someone different? Oh,
no. The Grand Colonial Front Desk warmly welcomes you, Inspector. It's a pleasure to see you again.
Thank you.
How may I be of assistance to you, Inspector?
Let's get to that. I thought the penthouse was being cleaned out for my stay, but it's a pigsty.
Oh, my. Well, that is certainly odd and alarmingly unacceptable. Allow me to check the service records.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, yes. Not to worry, Inspector. It was indeed cleaned for you. Except for the evidence, which is all of Helen's stuff.
Alright, I figured it was something like that. I need access to the VIP guest floor.
I'd love to, Inspector, but I don't really have the authority. Moreover, the guests were promised exclusivity. If I let you up there, I'll never hear the end of it.
The only guest who would have a problem with me being up there would be the murderer.
That's a good point. If they give me guff, I can just tell them that they're obstructing justice. That has a nice ring to it. Let me just set you up with VIP guest floor access. Done. You can now come and go as you please.
Yay. Sounds good to me. Alright. We have gained access.
What floor would you like to visit?
Alright. I would like to visit the VIP guest floor, please. Now.
If you see Black Hole Birdie, be sure to get an autograph for me. Just joking. I've already got one.
How does an elevator have someone's autograph? Rizzo Rangers and Slug Guard. Just hanging out near. Slug Security. You're looking at.
Why'd Helen have to go and die in our hotel? We don't need that kind of notoriety.
Birdie's a good fella. Powerful temper, though.
Yeah.
Hey there. You a fan?
Not exactly.
I'm pretty happy working for Slug. Mr. Kincannon treats us with respect.
Alright, well, we're supposed to go over there. Let's explore first. Zeke Hannigan.
Zeke Hannigan, Rizzo's Ranger 16th back. Pleased to meet you. What can I do for you?
16th back? Damn. How long have you been with the Rangers?
About half my life. You know I was named third most profitable investment on two non-consecutive seasons? Ain't a lot of players who can make that claim. Except for the guys who came in first and second, I guess.
What's going on?
I spent the last season injured and almost got sold to the Hephaestus Hammers. But now I'm all convalesced, ready to lay into some Cleo darlings, you know? Really break some legs.
Okay, what brings the Rangers to Eridanos?
Since it's the off-season, we're helping support the launch of Rizzo Spectrum Brown. Meet the fans, sign tossball cards, that sort of thing.
Right.
Just between you and me, Rizzo's ought to cancel the whole event out of respect for Miss Helen.
Alright, speaking about Halcyon Helen, I had some questions about her murder.
Oh, you must be that inspector people have been talking about. It's a damn shame about Miss Helen. She was always real good to me and the rest of the Rangers. Birdie's taking it pretty hard. Miss Helen was the love of his life. So, what did you want to know?
Tell me about Birdie and Helen.
Oh, Birdie was mad about Helen. He was certifiable. The big galoot loved Helen about as much as he loved the game. Trouble is, Birdie was not blessed with an abundance of temper. Helen kept Birdie steady. If he lost his temper around her, it'd be because something broke between the two of them.
You think Birdie could have killed Helen with that temper?
What? Law, no. Birdie's got a fierce temper, but there's no way he'd ever have laid a finger on Miss Helen.
You think of anyone who would want to kill Helen?
Miss Helen was outspoken. She made her share of enemies on account of her expressing herself. Just between you and me, I heard rumors the Prophet never much cared for Helen's brand of blunt honesty.
The Prophet, right? Come back to the Prophet. Okay, where were you at the time of the murder?
I'm ashamed to admit it, but me and a couple of the other Rangers spent the night in Constable Keene's cells down at the spaceport.
Oops.
We didn't do anything serious, just a bit of pranks and vandalism. It's what usually happens when we all get to drinking. Guess Constable Keene saw things a bit differently and had us hauled off.
Was Birdie in jail with the rest of you?
No, we lost him somewhere along the way.
Oh.
Or maybe he managed to get away? I can't rightly remember. But he was definitely not sharing a cell with us. That much I know.
Alright, let's talk about something else.
What can I do for you?
Nothing. Because I asked everything else. Oh, I thought I could have looked at this. I don't need your smoke that bad. Spectrum Vodka Black. Violet. Classic Wear Express. Oh, he's probably gonna see me grab that thing. All right. The hell happened here?
Top rungers are into some weird shit.
Oh, there's a bull or a yak here?
Beep, beep, beep. Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Is this dead? Oh, its ear moved. Timeline discrepancy. What is this thing? Looks like a stamp or something. Fall plaid collection. Hat, wide brimmed. This leather-related hat is rain-resistant and can be squished for easy storage. Fall plaid collection. Oh, it's joli cool. Elegant, eye-catching plaid will get you noticed. New this fall. Thank you. Oh, wait. We got a purple berry bunch. Black Hole Birdie signed toss ball. This toss ball signed by Birdie Black Hole Holcomb was presented to Dr. Margrave on a special guest episode of Space Hospital to thank her for removing a toss ball stick embedded in his head. Okay, then. Sounds like quite the episode. What the... So this is obviously Black Hole Birdie, sweet. What's this black stuff? Oops. Alright, let's see what we have here. I like it. Instead of going beep, 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 it says beep, beep, beep. Cap... build style A. This build cap is available in two different styles. This is style A. Fall plaid. It's too bad the stuff won't stack. Oh, I can level them up. I have one perk. When this companion takes damage, they gain some armor for a short time. This effect stacks up to 3 times. Stand your ground plus 3 armor rating for 10 seconds. And then Nayoka. I'll give her the same. Alright, so this discrepancy.
Multiple discrepancies detected. First discrepancy. A woolly cow is present in this hotel room.
That's
woolly
a bull.
Cows are
it's
an
horns.
Important species for the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve and are incapable of affording upper class accommodations.
Huh.
Second discrepancy. This woolly cow is dangerously inebriated with Rizzo Spectrum Vodka. Alcohol sanguinization ratio exceeds recommended maximum.
Yeah, cows generally can't afford things, but it has horns. This is a male, I think. And the recommended maximum blood alcohol ratio for a woolly cow is?
Zero.
So a cow can't have a good time in this colony?
This unit has not been programmed to include bovine jurisprudence in its library of information.
Sure.
A brief survey of this area reveals that the most recent occupants were athletes belonging to the Rizzo's Rangers Tossball Club.
How can you tell?
A brief survey of localized property damage divided by the area of this room yields the following estimate. This unit was likely occupied by every member of the Rizzo's Rangers. Minus one.
What are you guys doing? Ugh, relax. Alright. We'll finish our exploration next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.